Good day to all of us.
Ariel Jacto Franca here, and today we are going to learn on how to play chess. In playing the game chess, a player must first know on how to position the chessboard. Each player must have one black square on its lower left side. And after learning the positioning of the chessboard, the player must learn the movement and role of each piece. The first piece that we are going to learn is the rook. Rook is positioned at a1, h1, a8, and h8. The movement of a rook is straight horizontal or straight vertical. Rook cannot jump over pieces. So, for example, if a rook is blocked by a piece, for example, knight, it cannot move into the horizontal direction. So, if a piece is blocked by a pawn, it cannot move into vertical direction. So, in playing the game chess, players must first open up the path for the rook. For example, moving the a2 pawn into the a4 so that the rook can have its movement by doing the vertical movement. The next piece that we are going to discuss are knight. Knights are placed at b1, g1, b8, and g8. The movement of a knight are unique, for it shows an L-shaped movement. For example, movement of 2 vertical and 1 horizontal, which shows an L-shaped movement. It can also move 2 horizontal and 1 vertical, also shows L-shape. The horse is also unique, for it can move over pieces. For example, this piece of knight can move doing this L shape even if it is blocked by other piece, as long as the landing point or the position the knight is going to occupy next is empty. For example, 2 vertical and 1 horizontal. Even if the pawn is blocking the way of the knight, it can move for the position that the knight is going to landing was empty. The next piece that we are going to discuss are the bishop. Bishop are placed at c1, f1, c8, and f8. The movement of bishop are diagonal movement, given that it is the same color as its position. For example, this white piece, bishop, is positioned at a black square, so its movement is diagonal in all direction, given that it is a straight line to its position and it is in the same color as its position. The bishop cannot jump over pieces, so if a bishop is blocked by pieces like pawn, players usually open up the path for the bishop. For example, moving the first piece that is blocking the bishop. For example, the d2 moving it to the d4. So now that the pawn is open for the bishop, it can now move diagonally in this direction. The next piece that we're going to discuss was the queen. Queen is placed at d1 and in the other side is d8. Queen has the ultimate movement in the game chess, for it can move in all direction given that it is in a straight line. For example, it can move into this horizontal line or in here. It can move into the vertical line, giving it the complete optimum movement. So for example, usually players move their place their queen in the center board. And if you ask me why did players usually put this their queen in the center board, for it has the ultimate movement. As can be shown that the queen has a movement in all places as long as it has in a straight line. So it shows that it can move from here and going farther from here. Giving it more movement. The next piece that we're going to discuss is the king. The king is placed at e1 and e8. The king has the most limited movement, for it can only move one square at a time and in all directions. For example, one movement, one movement, one movement, one movement, one movement. The king is the most important piece in the game chess. For capturing the piece and doing checkmate wins you the game. Sometimes the king can also be checked by doing some capture movement into the king, even if it is not checkmate, just to destroy the positioning of the enemy line. The next piece that we are going to discuss is the pawn. The pawn is positioned at A2, from A2 to H2 in the first side. And A7 to H7. The pawn has a unique movement, for it can only move one space at a time, and its capture movement is in a diagonal position, in a one movement, one straight movement, here or here. In the game, in the start of a game, a pawn can move two spaces. For example, this pawn can move two spaces, this pawn can move two spaces, this pawn can move two spaces, and after that, this pawn pieces that have moved two spaces already will resume to its original movement, which is the one movement per one space, one movement. For example, here, here, here. And for example, if a pawn reaches the opposite side of the board, it can it can upgrade or evolve into other pieces. Example, this piece, you can make this into a queen, a bishop, a knight, or a rook. Next, we are going to discuss the points of each piece. For the piece rook, it has 5 points when capturing. For the piece horse, it has 3 points when capturing. For the piece bishop, it has 3 points when capturing. For the piece queen, it has 9 points when capturing. For the piece king, it was priceless as when capturing the king wins you the game. For the piece pawn, it has 1 point. So next, we are going to put all the pieces that we had discussed. This is the complete positioning of all pieces in the game chess. And that would be all. Thank you.